The Topp Twins should be celebrating. This year, Dames Lynda and Jools Topp mark 40 years performing as musicians, comedians and their beloved alter egos. The pandemic's kept them out of the spotlight and it's devastated their career. But there's even more significant news. They sat down with me to let us all know what's really going on.
Meet me, mama, meet me at the station door.
They've always been in sync. Looks like you had so much fun.
Yeah, we have. Yeah. And, you know, what's the point in life if you're not having fun?
From birth, they've shared everything. The songs, the stage, the ups and the downs. But for the first time, the twins, Lynda...
I miss you, buddy. You and me, we can do it. We're fighters, we're survivors.
And Jools Topp...
I need to be strong for you because you were strong for me.
...can't be together for the biggest challenge of their lives.
Sometimes I think it's the end of my journey and the start of yours.
You're in sync again.
Yeah, we're in sync.
In the worst way.
and not the greatest way, but we're back in sync.
It's beautiful country. A dry and dusky expanse lies between Christchurch and Methven.
Come on, Baba.
It's here among the braided Canterbury rivers.
It's just a, you know, awesome place to just chill out. You know, it's just there's good energy in rivers.
That Lynda Topp has made her home. Oh, this is a good space.
Yeah, this is my she shed.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
A she shed.
Every woman should have a she shed.
It's where we sat down. I wore my best denim shirt for you.
Yeah, you look real country.
Yeah, I was aiming for that, thank you. Excellent. To discuss the last tumultuous year for the Topp Twins. Well, I've got to say, it's quite unusual for me to sit here just with you.
Yeah.
And then I'll do that with Jools.
Yeah.
And I've only ever interviewed you together.
We've always had a rule that we get photographed together and we get interviewed together.
Yeah.
And then this is the first time that I have had to do this. And that was yesterday. I was a little bit frightened about that whole thing.
What were you
that
thinking?
Jools wouldn't be here.
That's because Jools Topp lives at the other end of the country, in Kaipara.
What's it like being apart?
It's hard. Although, you know, we've lived apart for a long time now. Lynda's a South Island girl. And, you know, I love the Kaipara. This is my home. It's beautiful. And, it's Auckland's best kept secret.
This is Jools's paradise.
And there's only two types of people in the world. There are horsey people and non-horsey people.
Though there's magic when you put them together.
I'm working my audience just like I'm working my horse, because you cannot force a horse to do anything. You set it up and allow him to find it.
You can lead an audience to the hall, but you can't make them laugh. But they always seem to. For 40 years, the twins have delighted here and around the world with their down-home brand of Kiwi country goodness and straight-up honesty.
We were country kids, we sang country music, we yodeled, we were lesbians, we were funny. That combination is weird. I mean, the fact, for the start, you know, lesbians and country music, that's not supposed to go together.
But it did. In sync always, particularly on stage.
My job is, you know, play the guitar. You know, make sure the music's right.
Boston, Massachusetts!
And Lynda is, she's looking at the crowd.
I suppose you think you know everything, do you?
Making sure the crowd's with us. Are they with us? What do we need to do? I mean, Lynda is the ultimate performer.
You people are in this shit, aren't you?
Because she can change tack anytime. I go, what the hell is that girl doing now? And I just have to go with her.
Over the decades, characters emerged that became as real as the twins themselves.
Braylon and Brenda, you know, Ken and Ken.
It's just the pure poetry to watch them work a dog.
You know, camp mother and camp leader. They're a tribute to New Zealand.
And a tribute to women.
New Zealand women are not afraid to stand up for themselves. And, you know, we've been trying to help that legacy, that women are amazing and cool and you know...
Untouchable.
That's the one.
Except in one very big way, Jools hasn't been untouchable. 16 years ago, she was diagnosed with breast cancer. She had a mastectomy and months of chemo.
How do you feel?
Like a million bucks.
We were dealing with media, we were dealing with her getting sick, and to watch her go through that was really traumatic.
Sometimes when I come to the hospital, I just feel hard, but I'm going to get around here pretty shortly and then I can get home again.
But Jools pulled through.
It was a miracle. We got through it and we went back and did the recovery tour.
Years passed, the cancer in remission. But then late last year, Jools began to feel unwell again.
And I said, what do you think it is? She said, I think my cancer might be coming back, you know? And so that made me extremely worried. But also it meant that I couldn't go to her.
In lockdown, Jools was without her sister when the worst was confirmed.
You know, my cancer's spread. It's metastasized through my body. I've got 6 tumors in my chest wall. It's in the bone of my sternum, and now it's gone into my throat. They did a CT scan, and now I've got a new tumor in between my 10th and my 9th rib. And it's the first time my cancer's ever really been painful.
So what does this mean for you, Jools? What's the prognosis?
Well, the prognosis is that the doctor now says I'm on palliative care, right? And that basically means I've got painkillers if it gets bad.
So does that mean you're out of options?
Well, I've got this new growth in my back. It's I can feel it. It's the first time a cancer's sticking out on my body, you know? I might be able to do some radiation on that. They've got way better at that, where they can just pinpoint the tumour and not burn the rest of you. Because as a lifelong member of Greenpeace, and I can't let them radiate me. Yeah. Just thought I can't do it.
And I just thought, I just want to be there, you know? Yeah. I just want to be there, but...
COVID has been crushing for the twins. Cancelled performances, their income gone. They can't be together, and now... cancer.
You know, I mean, we've been through so much. And...
But it's not the end of the bad news. There's a new gut-wrenching blow for Lynda.
I got a call saying we need to get you to come in. We'd like to do an ultrasound. We've found something. A couple of days later, it came back that I had grade 3 invasive breast cancer. So all of a sudden, boom, in COVID, can't be with Jools. And I sat in the car and I, you know, burst into tears.
After the break...
I'm a bit scared about doing my chemo. I'm a bit frightened.
What does this mean for the country's favourite twins?
I don't know which is harder, having cancer or not having Jools. Yeah.
And is this the end of the music?
Got something for you.
Oh, what's that?
Big bag of dope.
Jools Topp is on palliative care after her breast cancer metastasized.
What it really does is help with pain. Might have taken one more than I should have.
Yeah. She's taking cannabis oil.
What I'm experiencing now for the first time with my cancer is quite a lot of pain.
Jools lobbied for cannabis to be legalized.
It's a plant, people. How natural can you get? And I don't want medicinal marijuana from America. I want medicinal marijuana from New Zealand.
Homegrown, just like you.
Homegrown, just like me, yeah. Nuclear, spring
box, and tidal waves, and culture shocks. The Topp Twins may be known for their comedy, but their activism has been just as defining.
Jools and I have been fighters all our lives. We reckon that every change in history in New Zealand, we were there, and we wrote a song about it. Bastion Point, we were there for the Springboks tour. We were on the field in Hamilton. We were there for the homosexual law reform bill.
It was just about standing up for the right things.
Now both twins have cancer, but standing up again.
You know, now that I've got cancer and I've got to do 6 months worth of chemo, I just think this is my personal protest now.
The twins are tough. The strength comes from childhood.
I've been given all this beautiful stuff from my parents that it can make me go through this. You know, they made us strong. They don't know it, but they did.
Jools and Lynda were born in Huntley 63 years ago.
Mum didn't know she was having twins at that point. Jools and I were so in sync with our heartbeats, they only ever heard one heartbeat.
It was a country upbringing with their parents and big brother Bruce.
And we loved the farm. We learnt beautiful things, you know, how to fix a fence, how to fix a trough, how to change a tyre.
Then Bruce bought them a guitar.
And it came with a book that said, play in a day. And Jools read that book that day and played in a day, and then she threw the book away.
Lynda says she learned guitar by a type of twin osmosis. The same happened with yodeling.
I just practiced and practiced and practiced. And then Jools never learned to yodel. But when I sang the first yodel, she sang beside me a harmony yodel.
Here we go now.
And I'm going, I spent 7 years trying to figure this out. And then on the first time we sing that song, you just come in with a harmony. I'm going, what's going on there? I did all the hard work with this.
She's in my veins, you know. We're blood, you know. She's in my veins.
Twins, always in sync, but now in the worst possible way.
We should be celebrating a big national tour right now.
You should be, but yeah, you're not.
We're not. And even if we could, we wouldn't be able to because we're both sick, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not often you can say the whole band has cancer.
For Jools, who's lived with cancer for 16 years, her sister's phone call was shocking.
She just said, "I've got cancer." She just said, "I've got cancer."
What was that phone call like for you?
It was pretty hard. Just went into shock a bit, really, and then I just burst into tears, just cried and cried and cried, uncontrollable crying, sobbing, crying.
I think, you know, everybody can find a place of healing, you know, yeah. For me, it's the rivers and looking at the mountains. But I think for Jools, it's horses, riding a horse. But for me, it's walking the rivers.
Lynda, who had a double mastectomy in December, is now facing chemo.
Are you frightened?
Am I frightened? I find myself holding my hands here because there was a moment when I remember thinking in the car, what am I going to do about Camp Mother? Because Camp Mother, she's got lovely big breasts that have been holding up those jumpsuits for 30-odd years. And I cried about that.
It's the night before Lynda's first chemo treatment.
Yeah, sometimes I think it's the end of my journey and the start of yours.
I know, I'm a bit scared about doing my chemo. I'm a bit frightened. And the fact that you can't be here with me. I'd really like you to be here with me, buddy.
Because of COVID, the twins are protecting each other by staying apart.
I'm possibly, you know, a threat to come down from Auckland, you know, with the COVID.
Yeah, I know.
It would be really terrible if I killed you by coming and bringing COVID down. That would be terrible.
I'm here with her, Jules.
I know. But I also know that, you know, I'm compromised too now with my new tumour, so I just...
Lynda has wife Donna to look after her.
Okay, buddy.
I know she's in good hands, Donna.
I don't know which is harder, having cancer or not having Jools.
While Jools takes comfort in Lynda's wife Donna being there, it's different for her.
I've chosen to be single. And I chose to be single because I have cancer.
Huh.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I know that at some point in time I'm going to go. I won't be here. And I don't want someone to get that close. And I think I'm protecting myself. I'm exhausted. You know, I'm dealing with my cancer every day of my life, and sometimes I think I wouldn't be able to give all myself to somebody. It's just too hard.
Jules says the love of friends and her horses is helping her through. Do you get frightened though, Jules?
No, I haven't heard that feeling yet. Might do one day, who knows?
You must have thought about this. As you navigated your own illness and now as Lynda is navigating hers, what life might be like without one another?
Well, there'd be tears before bedtime if one of us died. I don't know that much. Because, you know, that's going to be hard.
But can you do without Lynda?
I'll have to. And she'll have to do without me. We go on living. It's really important to know that, you know, sometimes you just, in death, we might find strength.
I talked to Lynda, you know, yesterday, and she said to me, just go down there, Jules, just go down there every now and then and put your feet in the water, because all the rivers that I'm going to be in somehow will eventually connect to the sea. So even though I might not be there with Lynda, I can reconnect with her if I go down here and put my feet in the water.
Good girl. Come on.
As serious as things are, neither twin is planning an imminent nor quiet exit.
Yeah, I want to live. I want to live and Jules wants to live. I might outlive the lot of you. We don't know.
You're not contemplating the end?
No, this is a new beginning. This is a new beginning for Jules and me. So Jules has to get her pain under control. I have to get through my chemo. And there's a 40th anniversary that needs to be celebrated. It's just another
highway, just another road. The music, they say, will never stop. But is it realistic with your illness?
If I can hold a guitar and stand in front of a mic, there'd be no stopping me.
I don't think it matters if it's realistic. It's what we want to do. You know, maybe one of us passes away in a motel somewhere in a small town, waiting to do a gig, you know. The Topp Twins will always be the Topp Twins and we'll always want to perform.
I love it. You'll perform till lights out.
Perform till the lights out, I like that.
Are they amazing, amazing women? Well, Jules started radiation on Wednesday for her latest tumour. Meanwhile, Lynda's chemo is tough. She has 6 months of it ahead. Our thoughts and energy are with them both. Now, if you'd like to stay updated with Jules and Lynda's journey, please go to our Facebook page for more.